Hey guys, welcome back. So today I wanted to show you my updated foundation sort of like face routine without the eyeshadow stuff. If you want to see the eyeshadow, I can recreate it and refilm that part. But yeah, this is how I wear my foundation. This is what my face looks like most of the time. Obviously, because I work in an education environment, I don't wear this much makeup, but the foundation is what I wear every day, just that the eyeshadows are a little bit more mellow. Okay, so if you want to see what my foundation routine is and also hear about what I think about Sephora Australia, then keep watching. So before anything else, when I do my makeup, after I get out of the shower, I spritz myself with skincare lotion. I don't know what this is called, but and what brand it is even, but I got this from one random Asian supermarket here in Australia, in Sydney. It's actually right behind Woolies in Town Hall. So anyway, there's like 500 ml in here and it was like less than $20, I think. And it's based on, it's got rice wine as its base. So it's sort of like the, sort of like SK2, I think it is. And it's really helped my skin. It also makes it a little bit tacky so that whatever I put over it is great. What? As you can tell, I haven't been filming in a while, so I'm probably very rusty when it comes to talking to you guys. But yeah, and then the next thing is I layer it with the La Roche-Posay Cero Zinc, which is meant to control the oiliness of your skin. It says here cleansing and soothing, but what I find as well is that I used to be quite acne prone. I don't know if it's because of my age now that I'm not as acne prone as I used to be, but this is really good for controlling that. And it also, I feel that also my makeup doesn't really move that much when I've got that underneath. And obviously, because I am in Australia, the sun here is so extreme that I always have to put on SPF. And the one that I use is the Sun Sense Daily Face, and this has got SPF 50, yeah. And it's a tinted invisible finish. It has a little bit of tint, but I don't really see it on my skin. It's lightweight and it is matte formula. I hated, there was one that I bought from, what do you call that, from iHerb, and it said it was extra emollient, and then it looked like I slathered oil on my face, and that was not the look that I was going for. When I saw that this had a matte formula, I went for it. It's even better than, my favorite used to be the Neutrogena Healthy Defense, I think is what it is, the lightweight one, but this has taken over that. This is like 75 grams, and I think it's around about $10 to $13 depending on where you get it. I usually get mine from Chemist Warehouse just because it's cheaper. I also get my La Roche-Posay from Chemist Warehouse. If you're in Australia, you know what that is, because makeup here in Australia is exorbitantly priced, especially the drugstore ones. Like the drugstore makeup here is about the same price as Sephora makeup in the US. That's how bad it is. Like foundations are like $30. Anyhow, so that's the base that's on my face right now. Nothing else is on there. Now I'm gonna show you my foundation routine. Enough with the blabbering. Now, because summer is what we have in Australia right now, my skin is also darker. I am usually an NC35 during the cold months here. But sometimes I even go up to NC30. But now that it's summer and I have been to the beach a few times, I am now a MAC NC40. This is like the perfect shade for me. I also am the shade, what is this? This is the Estee Lauder Perfectionist Youth Infusing Serum Makeup. And this is 4N1, which means it's neutral, shell beige. This is also the perfect shade for me, and this is the one that I'm going to use today. For drugstore, I have the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation in 07 Sand. I used to have the L'Oreal Infallible Total Cover, and I had it in shade number 32. It was too pink for me and quite dark. Oh, well, the shade is probably right, but the undertone is wrong, so it just made me look ashy pink. Anyways, this works well for me as well. And I've recently purchased one of the smaller It Cosmetics CC cream, and this is in the shade tan because the color medium is too light for me, so I kind of like mix them together. This is like the foundations that I have. That's all the foundation that I have now. I used to have a ton of foundations, but now I'm like paring down my collection, and this is what I have. This is like sort of my everyday combination, especially when I don't feel like putting my SPF. This already has SPF 50, so that's pretty good. But for the purpose of this video, I am going to be using the Estee Lauder Perfectionist. I have primers here, and I'll show you. I recently bought, and I'll do a proper video of the recent makeup purchases that I've done. There isn't much, to be honest with you, in the span of what? From August, which was when I did my last video, up till Christmas, I didn't really buy makeup. And the ones that I bought, I think I bought the Huda Beauty Desert Dusk palette. And I sold that because it just wasn't for me. That glitter just keeps falling on my face. Anyway, for primer, I bought the Becca, what are these called? First Light Priming Filter, and this is the Backlight Priming Filter. I thought I'd try the purple one because my skin has got a lot of gold and yellow undertone to it, so I thought it would neutralize that a little bit, and it's meant to be for sullen skin. But I just don't really see any difference when I wear this. Now, the Backlight Priming Filter is actually quite nice, and I do like it. So I'm gonna be, I don't know, will I use it? I don't know. I also have the Max Drope Cream, which I know is not technically a primer. It's supposed to be a hydrating cream. It's got a bit of a sheen to it. I also like to use this on my foundations or underneath to sort of give it a little bit of a glow. Now, the one that I'm currently using is the Ordinary High Adherence Silicone Primer. Now, I wasn't really a big fan of this when I first got it, but then after I've tried it, and what I actually did was to put it underneath my eyes because then it helps the concealer glide and also to stay put and fill in my like little fine lines underneath my eyes. So I'm gonna be using this today. For eyeshadow primer, I have been using the Milani eyeshadow primer, and this isn't my favorite. It's good for what it does, I suppose, because it's summer here and it's quite humid, that it doesn't really work as well as my NARS eyeshadow primer does, but I still use it. It's all right. And let me just go through what I'm going to be using for concealer as well. Along with that, those Becca primers, I got this mini of the Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector. Now, I wasn't impressed with this when I first tried it on. I thought that it made my my under eyes look really sort of oily and wet. And I was like, what? How does that work? And then I realized that I had my MAC Pro Conceal and Correct. Now, granted, I could have used this shade here, but this is pretty matte. It's not luminous. So I actually would combine this with this here, which is this shade NC35, since I'm darker now. And that sort of lightens the under eyes and makes it look pretty perfect, actually. So, enough with the blabbing, as I already said that earlier, but I'm just going to go ahead and do this now. And then I'm probably going to be ranting about Sephora Australia while I'm doing my foundation. So, here we go. So, I'm a member of Sephora Loyalty Club here in Australia. I have given up my US VIB status a long time ago. I think maybe it's been like 2 years now since I have I have no longer been a VIB. Anyways, so I can't even start with this. Now with Sephora in Australia, you're supposed to purchase up to $300 worth of makeup within 12 months to qualify for their black tier. When you become a member, you are a white tier. So that's their very basic one, or what would be equivalent to the Beauty Insider in the US. Now here, it's the white. Now to be a VIB, or the black tier, you should spend $300 within 12 months. And that's exactly what I did. From April 2017 until December 2017, I spent about $311. Okay, most of those stuff I have already also sold and decluttered because they didn't work for me. And here we don't have the same return policy as you have in the US, where you can pretty much return whatever you want. Here, if it's already been opened, you can't return it. Anyways, so I've spent $300 in less than 12 months. But then when I inquired why my tier hasn't changed, they said to me that I was only qualifying with $259, I think it was. And I was like, well, that's not right, because I then showed them the screenshots of the orders that I've made with Sephora, and they said, oh, but the qualifying dates are October 2016 to October 2017. And I said, where in your FAQ about Beauty Pass is that indicated? And when did you give out that information? Because apparently they did a revamp of their program, and so the qualifying periods are now October 2016 to 2017, and you will not find that anywhere on their website. All it says is that you need to spend $300 within 12 months, which is what I did, okay? And then they come back to me, oh, you don't qualify. And I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? I just spent $311, and I show them all of my orders. And they were like, oh, yeah, the period is like, well, explain to me this, because you don't have that information anywhere on your website. And they just kept repeating the same shit to me. And I'm like, look, unless you have that in your website to say that you guys have that qualifying period thing, which honestly I had a look multiple times and there was none. There was no information about that. And look, it's pretty easy to just give me my black tier, because I did spend that money, and they can see it on their website. But all they keep telling me was that, oh, but the qualifying period, but the qualifying period. And I'm like, you never said anything about a qualifying period. You never said anything that I had to do with between October 2016 to 2017. All it ever said was that you have to do it within 12 months, and I did it in 8 months. Okay? Which normally, if it was like my previous self, that would have happened in 1 month. I would have spent $300 in 1 month. But anyway, I did it in 8 months, and all they ever say to me is, oh no, sorry, you can't. So I mean, I complained a lot, and it's just like over and over and over and over. They are absolutely shitheads. And I said, look, well, show me where you have that information printed for everyone to see, because it's not there. It's not. Even now, it's not. As I'm filming this, it's not there. Ooh. Forgot to put on primer. Smart, Meg. Anyway, I've already put in my concealer and put in my foundation, so we'll just probably skip the primer because it's already not there. Anyways, so yeah, and they just keep telling me the same thing. I keep telling them, look, I don't understand, and I refuse to understand your logic, especially when you don't give out that information to your clients. That is so unfair and anti-consumer. So I was like, that's bullshit, man. And even now, they haven't credited me with my points. So, what's the deal, Sephora? And this is like the Sephora in Asia, not there, because the Sephora Australia is linked to the one in Singapore, and that's how they handle their customers. Amazing, right? So, in the end, I said to them, look, if this is how you're going to treat your customers, and if this is how your policy is going to be, then I refuse to buy from Sephora anymore. I said to them, I don't care. I don't even care about my points anymore. And it's good if I don't become a black tier member, because honestly, your reward system is shit anyways. They'll give you like 10% off, a birthday gift. You get invited to whatever events, but that's it. They don't have those VIB sales that the US does. So I'm like, well, there is no real reason for me to actually join this thing. And in fact, Mecca Cosmetica's loyalty program is probably better. So I am probably going to move to Mecca Cosmetica and buy from them instead. They are the original Sephora of Australia in the first place. The only thing is they don't have the same products. Mecca has exclusivity to, let's say, NARS, Hourglass, Urban Decay, Too Faced, what else? Smashbox. Whereas Sephora has exclusivity to, let's say, Anastasia Beverly Hills, Makeup Forever, all those other brands. So if I wanted to buy something from those brands, I will have to go to Sephora, but I refuse to do that. I'd rather like buy from Sephora US and ship it to me than to buy from here, because I just refuse. And actually, I am going to boycott every single Sephora, because the Sephora in the US has refused to use forwarding addresses, have refused to accept international card. Well, I think I still can use international cards. Yeah, but forwarding addresses is no longer accepted. So I'm like, what is this, Sephora? I thought you might want to have my money, but it seems like you don't. So anyway, I'm boycotting Sephora Australia, probably boycotting Sephora Asia, for that matter, since they're all linked together and they have that stupid policy. Yeah, and that's my base. Let me go ahead and do my eyes and my eyebrows, and I'll come back to you with how I sort of like finish the rest of the face. Okay, now that I've got my eye makeup done, the wind is howling outside, I swear. It's like pushing all of my windows. That's the noise that you're probably hearing. But anyways, now that I've got my eye makeup done, and if you want to see how I did this, let me know in the comment section down below, because I can recreate it for you guys, but that's what it looks like. Let's proceed with the rest of the face. I'm just going to take one of these angled brushes that I have, and my light contour from the Lorac, what is this called? Pro Contour Palette. And I'm just going to contour my nose. And blend that. And then I'm going to take this brush from Delium. Oopsie. And what am I going to do? Oh, yeah. Medium contour shade from this palette. Tap off excess on my face. I think I'm gonna have to close the blinds a little bit so you can actually see. There you go. A little bit of that on the forehead as well. Whatever's left on the jawline. Now, something that I've actually been loving again is this MAC Freshen Up Highlighter Powder. Now, this is obviously limited edition based on the packaging, but I've been liking this as my highlight. Now, I'm gonna take, this is a Sigma F35 tapered brush, And I'm gonna swirl that into these light shades here. Apply that on my cheekbones. Even a little bit of it on the bridge of my nose. Okay. And then I'm gonna swirl the same brush into the pink and peach one. Tap off excess and use that as my blush. Now sometimes I go a little bit too much with the blush, so I'll just go back in with my Real Technique sponge and go over it by tapping, and that sort of sorts it out. Okay, we can reopen the blinds a little bit. There you go. And I'm gonna choose a lip color that would complement this look. So let's see. Mm-hmm. How about ColourPop? I can't even get it out of the container. What is this? Jiffy? Yeah, Jiffy. So a little bit of a light nude. Now, as a final step to all of these, I have my Tarte Smooth Operator setting powder. This is translucent. It has no color at all. And because I forgot to put on my primer, even though most of the time, even if I do put on primer, because of the consistency of that concealer from Becca, I would still use this Smooth Operator setting powder. And I like to do it at the very end when I've seen how much powder I've already put on my face and if I still need it. So I usually just put it underneath my eyes, and that sort of blurs out whatever fine lines and pores that I can see through. And then because I put so much powder on my face, I would go in with my Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray, especially because it's summer here. I want my makeup to last instead of melt off. So I just spray. And it takes away the powderiness of everything that I put on my face, but also seals in the makeup. And this is going to last me the whole day. So yeah, that is the makeup that I have on, and that is my foundation routine. Okay, so let me just talk you through what I used on my eyes as well. So I used the Lorac Pro Contour Palette, and I used the light contour all over the crease, so that sort of is the transition shade. I used the deep contour at the outer V. And I use the beige highlight to highlight my brow bone. The same product is used to contour my nose, to chisel the cheekbones, which you probably don't even see because of the lights, but you can tell from there. Yep. I also used, for the main eyeshadow, the green that you're seeing on here is from Inglot, which is the shade right here. And if you want the, it is 414, if you can even see that from the silver, but the color is Inglot Eyeshadow 414. Loving this shade. Remember the time when everybody was all about the brown and green or brown and blue shades? And now it's all the orange and rust and whatever. So yeah, I'm going back to that bluish green or greenish brown shade. I also went in with my Anastasia Nicole Guerrero Glow Kit and used that white shade here called Forever Lit. and foiled it and placed it at the center. So that's the sort of like silver bluish shade that you're seeing, like the halo effect. Okay, now for my eyeliner, I use the Maybelline New York Hyper Sharp Winged Liner, and this is the one with a purple with a purple lid, which is thick on one side and thin on the other. So it's actually pretty easy, and it's a brush eyeliner, so I really like that. What else did I use on my eyes? I use my Revlon, what is this called, Precision Dark Lash Adhesive. I don't really like this, especially when I'm not wearing eyeliner. I would prefer, I actually do like the Daiso one, but I've run out of it, so I actually need to purchase another one, and it's like $2 as opposed to, this is I think something like $7 here in Australia, maybe more. $7 when it's on sale, right? And for eyelashes, I also use the Daiso. These I get from Daiso, and it's just called the Daiso Cosmetics Impact Lashes. That's what they are. They are nothing like mink lashes or anything like that, but they serve the purpose. And these are sort of like demi wispies where it splays out, and it's longer on the outer sides than in the inner ones. Okay, and you've seen everything else. Oh, on my eyebrows, I also used the dark contour shade from the Lorac, which I probably should use a little bit darker because they're pretty light for my hair, although they kind of go together with the ends of my hair here, which is a little bit lighter than the crown. So there, that is the makeup look. The only thing that actually changes is which foundation I use. If I want a fuller coverage, sort of like perfect skin foundation, then I use my MAC Studio Fix Fluid. If I want something like something more natural, then I use the Estee Lauder Perfectionist. If I want perfect with SPF but also natural, then I use the IT Cosmetics CC cream. And yeah, that's pretty much it. And thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and my little bit of a rant. If you have your own experience with Sephora Australia, I would love to hear it. Just so I know that I'm not alone. And yeah, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.